श्री अद्वैता गदाधारा शिवा सादि गौर भक्त वृंदा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे हरे। I would like to take the blessings for all of the assembled Vaishnavas so that I can speak something on the subject matter of Srimad Bhagavatam and Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Hare Krishna. So as it's 7-2, so we'll start. Today we are not discussing from Bhagavad Gita. Does anyone has any input from what would be the topic? Any guess for today what would be the topic?
About Purushottam Mas?
Yes, Mataji, rightly said. Yeah, because we all know that tomorrow Purushottam month is starting. So we'll gear up every one of us so that we can follow Purushottam month with all our heart and love and devotion to Shri Shri Radha and Krishna. So as Mataji has predicted correctly, we'll discuss about the Purushottam month. Is anybody here haven't heard about Purushottam month? I think each one of us. But anybody would like to know if they haven't heard about Purushottam month?
Yes, Mataji, I've never heard. This is the first time I'm hearing it.
Okay. Thank you, Prabhu.
And I heard, Mama.
Okay, good to see. So, yeah, so we'll discuss. It will be a very beautiful discussion because it's a beautiful month coming from tomorrow onwards. So, what is Purushottam month? First of all, we'll,
if you can give me the background, what is this char mas and exactly, I never understood this concept.
Yes, Prabhu. So I will try to build up the concept. And if you have any question, you can unmute yourself and speak.
Sure. Thank you.
Yes, so actually Chaturmas, if I give you the background, is Chaturmas starts from, I think, Asar, like mid of the July. And from Chaturmas, we have the Purushottam month is entirely different from Chaturmas. So Chaturmas, we first month, we fast from spinach and green leafy vegetables. For 1 month, we do not eat that. Second month, we fast from the curd. So 1 month, we follow the fast where we can do not take curd at all in our preparations and never eat it like plain. And third month, that is currently going on, we have a fast from the milk. So, but here is a break because the Purushottam month has been introduced from tomorrow till 16th of October. So 17th September to 16th October is Purushottam month. So then we do not have to fast for milk from milk because this month is entirely different. And the milk fast will continue from 17th of October, I think, till another 15 days. So might be 1st November would be the fourth month. When the Kartik starts, you have a fast from Urad Dal. So you should not consume the Urad Dal. That's a fast from 1 month in the Kartik. That will start the last Chaturmas, fourth month of the Chaturmas. So very, very significant to do the devotional activities, but all of the Chaturmas is Purushottam month. It doesn't come every year. So I'll explain how it comes, why it only comes after only certain number of years. So what happens, as we know about the moon and the sun. So in the Vedic calendar, we follow the two, lunar calendar and the solar calendar. So when the moon, starts, they go round about, right? So they go in their orbit. So moon complete the orbit wherever it was there in the starting position. It comes to that starting position after 354 days. So around 354 days, it completes. And for the sun, it completes the orbit. The sun, its own orbit, it completes in 365 days. So in every year, in the lunar calendar and the solar calendar, there is a difference of 11 days. 11 days summers. So it's around 11 days difference will come every year. So two, and if you calculate exactly, it's around 3 years. But exactly, if you say so, it comes around 2 years, 8 months, 8 or 9 months. So around, you know, whenever it's going to complete 3 years. So if you calculate, it's around 32 days will be happening when this comes. 30 or 32 days will be added. So 2 years, right? 11 into 2, 22, and then again after before completing 3 years, this Purushottam month appeared. So this has appeared in 2017. Now it's 2020. So very, very glorious month. But if you ask any Karma Kandi, they will say that this month is a very bad month. So they blaspheme this month. So the story goes from here that because this is Adhik Mas, so people call it as Adhik Mas, Malamas. This is the name. So what happened one time? I'm going to go the background, how this, you know, how this month goes to the Lord, and then how it came into existence as Purushottam month. So, and we know in the Vedas, all of the things, like if you take the ocean, it's personified, right? The person behind it. If a mountain, there is a person behind it. Sun, you know, sun god. Moon, you know, moon god. So even the planets, we know, right? So for example, Earth, we have Bhumi Devi. So the god is Earth. So likewise, for the month also, we have some presiding deity. So every month has a presiding deity. It's a person. Like we are a person, they are the person. So this Adhik Mas, because it used to call it as Adhik Mas, this Adhik Mas as it comes, and why it comes, because it balances that lunar calendar to solar calendar, because if it continue goes on increasing will be very high. So that extra month, and it never comes in between the 12 months, it comes at the 13th month. So it's a added month in the lunar calendar to balance it to the solar calendar. I think it is clear till here. So what happens one time, and people, you know, Karma Kandi, they say this month is Malamas. So why they say it a Malamas? Because no tithis, like you will see no marriages will be happening, no housewarming ceremony will be happening, no new, I think people won't even buy new things like car or whatever is house or whatever is there. So so this month has no auspicious tithis like earlier, you know, when it was called Adhik Mas. So this Adhik Mas, because as I explained, all the in the Vedic, all are the personified. So this Adhik Mas lady, who was the, you know, the presiding deity for this month, she was very, very, very much upset, because everybody, every human being used to criticize, this month is very bad. Oh, we cannot perform any of the activities. A very bad month is coming. Like that, they used to blaspheme this month. So this lady, because nobody was respecting this month, so this lady was very much hurted. And she went to, where she went? She went to Lord Narayana. So she went in the Vaikuntha Loka to meet Lord Vishnu and explain her condition. So she says, she really cries a lot. She cries and she says, my Lord, I am the extra. People are calling me that there is no use of this month. This is an extra month. We cannot perform any activities. And people even stool, right? Malla means a stool. It is untouchable. So people even calling me as a Mallamas, and very, very bad name they are giving to me. So Lord Vishnu says, please do not cry. We will help you out. So I will help you out. But you do not cry. You have taken shelter of me. Rest assured that, you know, you will get justice. So then Lord Vishnu take this Mallamas, this lady, to Golok Vrindavan, to Krishna. So when they go, this lady is still crying. So when they go, the Goloka effulgence is very, very, very much high. So this lady, you know, she hides behind Lord Vishnu. So when they enter, but she's still crying. So Krishna hears this voice of crying. So Krishna will be thinking, who is crying in Goloka Vrindavan? Nobody cries. What does Brahma says in Brahma Samhita? Katha, Ganyam, Natyam, that verse is there in Brahma Samhita, where Brahma explains that every step is a every step is a song, every you know, every step is a dance, like that. There is a words exactly, I don't remember the complete verse, but you know, it's a very joyful place. So then Lord Vishnu introduced, they both pay the obeisances to Lord Krishna, and then Lord Vishnu introduce this lady to Lord Krishna, and then he says that this is the Malamas lady, and she's crying because people are giving her very bad name because she do not have any auspicious days, all those things. Lord Vishnu explains, then Lord Krishna says, you do not cry from, because in Goloka nobody cries. So I would like to add a little bit here, because you know, there is a very nice pastime. The crying happens in Goloka, but that's a different crying, not crying for any material thing, but they, you know, cry for Krishna. So one time what happened, when Krishna was in Dwarika, he was it's just to explain the crying. We are just taking a little diversion. So Krishna, Krishna was in Dwarika and he was sleeping. So we all know that all the queens, they will go to Mother Rohini and they say that we serve the Lord very much, you know, but again, the Lord remembers the gopis, the Vrindavan so much that he cries in the night. So Krishna used to cry in separation with the gopis. So one time what happened, it's a Dan Keli Komati, from Dan Keli Komati, a pastime where Lalita Sakhi, Radharani, they all Sakhis was going to Mathura to sell their butter and, butter and yogurt. So they have the pot. So Lalita Sakhi and Radharani, they talk with each other. And then Lalita asked which route we should take to go to Mathura. Then Radharani says, let's take this route. So they take that route, and here in that route, they meet Krishna. So Radharani, she was behind Lalita. She has this pallu till here. So Krishna have not seen Radharani. And then he told to Lalita, where are you going? So they say that we are going to sell. So then Krishna says, how can you go? You have to pay taxes. Without paying the taxes, you cannot use the road. It's not the road, you know, you can use like that. So I am the higher person for tax for tax collection from King Kamsa. So then they say like that. Krishna says like that. Then Lalita says, oh really, do you they talk with each other, and then they say, okay, who is behind you? And then when Radharani, they were talking with each other, and they say, Radharani said, Lalita, who asked you to take this route? I don't know that thieves are here, because Krishna wanted to take the pot, pot of yogurt and ghee as a part of tax collection. So Radharani and Lalita, they were talking with each other. Then Lalita said that you have only asked me to take this route. And then when Krishna saw Radharani, then he was like, okay, destiny is not in favor of me. He says that if Radharani would have been my wife, I am not sure why, Radharani's husband, she's so beautiful. Why he is even sending her out just to sell some butter and ghee and curd. So if she would have been my wife, I would have, kept her inside the house only, never allowed her to go outside. And, nicely, I have seated her in a golden throne. And then Lalita's behavior, as we know, she is a very fiery Sakhi. So she just tit to tat, she just say Krishna, like she just reply like that. So Lalita Sakhi say, oh really, Krishna, if somebody takes that golden throne, what you will do? Then Krishna says, no problem, I will keep Radharani in the throne of my heart. And then Lalita says, oh really, that means you're black heart, because you are black, so your heart is also black. So then Krishna becomes angry a little bit, and then he says, no, you are coming to a personal point. Don't tell anything about black color. Black color is so unique and beautiful. So Lalita says, what is unique about black color? Then Krishna says that if you see the if your hair wouldn't have been black, how would you look, Lalita? If your eyeballs, if they are not black, how would you look like that? You know, they argue. Then Krishna says, okay, why I'm even arguing with you? I just want my tax. Let me know how many pots you are taking so that I can take the tax based on you know, number of pots. And then, you know, they started like a little bit fight. And then Lalita is pulling Krishna's chadar. And then Krishna says, and he's all seeing this in his dream in Dwarika. So he just, you know, while sleep, sometimes we might have seen when we are in deep, intense dream, we will be doing exactly the same thing. So then Krishna says in that, I mean, while every queen was there surrounding Krishna, and Krishna was saying, Lalita, leave my chadar, like that. And he was crying, where is my gopis? Then he realized I'm in Mathura. So that kind of crying happened in spiritual world, but only for Krishna, or Krishna cries for gopi. So then we are going back to our discussion. So here, Malamasa Devi, you know, Krishna says, you don't cry. So I will give you all potencies and power to you. So I will marry you. So basically Krishna marries. So what happens usually when a girl get married, she get the name of her husband, like, you know, the surname of her husband. So that's how this month got the name of Purushottama month. And when this month itself got the name Purushottama, this month has, you know, Krishna has infused all these qualities here. So exactly, Krishna has, you know, put it all the qualities of air, his quality, pastime, everything. So Krishna says that whoever performs this Purushottam month will live very peacefully in this life, and he will attain to me as well. So and there is an this Purushottam month story is there, but this conversation, how it is happening, actually there is some pastime about Draupadi which I would like to discuss here. So four conversation is happening. So what is happening here? Sutta Goswami, we know Sutta Goswami, who was speaking in Nimaisharana with this 88,000 sages. They have asked them about this glories. So then Sutta Goswami takes them to you know, Sukhdev Goswami, because he have heard from Sukhdev Goswami when he has spoken to Parikshit Maharaj. But Sukhdev Goswami refer, right, when we refer to some other conversation. So Sukhdev Goswami was referring to the conversation about the glories of Purushottama month when Narada Muni asked in Badri Narayana from Nar Narayana Rishi. So when Nar Narayana Rishi, we know Narayana is Lord Narayana himself, and Nar is Arjuna. So he asked from Lord Narayana, what is this Purushottama month? How we should observe it? What we should do? So then Lord Narayana himself told that I will tell you the story which Lord Krishna himself is telling to Yudhishthira Maharaj. So when Yudhishthira Maharaj and all the Pandavas, after they have lost, you know, in the gambling and all the things they have lost, they went to the Kamyavan forest. So there, when Krishna goes to visit them, he was very, very angry, and he was, you know, he was just about to destroy the whole world. He's a Lord, he can do that too. So then Lord, you know, Yudhishthira pacified the Lord. He says that, my Lord, please be pacified, be calm, you know, calm down. And then they ask, what is the, you know, why we are suffering? So what is the reason of our suffering? Then Lord Krishna says, since you have not followed the Purushottama month, the glories of Purushottama month are so high, that's why you are suffering. And then Lord Krishna, which I've already told you, Lord Krishna told this story about Adhik Mas, and how, you know, this Adhik Mas got this name of Purushottam. Krishna only have given its all the potencies to this month. Whoever observe this month will definitely get, you know, very, very higher position in devotional service. So we will discuss what all vratas we can do in Purushottam month later on, but before here. And then Draupadi also asks, so what is the reason of my suffering? Then Lord Krishna tells, so now we'll go back to Draupadi's last life, which has been told, that story Krishna is telling to them when they were in Kamyavan. So Lord Krishna says, you were the daughter of Medhavi. So Rishi Medhavi was the father of Draupadi in her previous life. He was a Brahmana. So at the time of birth, this Draupadi, so previous life, she was the girl of Medhavi, Medhavi Rishi. So when this girl was born, her mother died. So, as soon as she was born, her mother died. So Rishi was the one who took care of her, who raised the daughter. But he was so much absorbed in the austerities because she grew up and she became at the young age. So usually young age, the girls get married. Similarly for boys get married. So since nobody is reminding him to get her married, Medhavi, Rishi have never thought of getting her daughter married. He was so much absorbed in austerities. So then what happened, this Rishi is, he died, but this girl is seeing that her sakhis are getting married. So, and his father is not arranging. She was a little morose, but her father died. So he left his body. Then what happened, Durvasa Muni visit the Brahmani girl of Medhavi. So Durvasa Muni happens to be the good friend of Medhavi Rishi. So when Durvasa Muni come, this girl, serves very nicely to Durvasa Muni, meal she serves. She serves very nicely to Durvasa Muni. Then she was very morose. Then she asked, Durvasa Muni asked her, why you are so morose? What do you want? Tell me. So Durvasa Muni asked her, then she said that I have no shelter. There is no mother, father, there is no relative. I want a husband because I want to get protected. I want a shelter. So then, Durvasa Muni says that no problem. Everything will become very good for you. From some time now, Purushottam month is coming. And this Purushottam month is very, very powerful. So you might have all heard about Kartik month. So even Jay Pataka Maharaj, he says, in one of his lecture, he says that Kartik month is 100 times powerful than all the other month to perform the devotional service. But this Purushottam month is 1,000 times more powerful than Kartik month. So it is very, 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 very powerful for performing devotional service. So similarly, Durvasa Muni, being aware of the glories of Purushottam month, told this Brahmini girl to observe this Purushottam month. And then this girl says that, what you're talking, Durvasa Muni, this is a Mal Mas, she started blaspheming this month. Because as you know, if you ask most of the people, being even coming to ISKCON or, not knowing the glories of Purushottam, they say this is a Mal Mas, no good tithis are there. No, we cannot perform marriage, engagement, no any sort of auspicious, so-called auspicious activity, you could say. So this girl started blessing this month, and then she says that no, this is a Mal Mas, why you are asking me to perform, who perform any good activity in this month, like that she started saying. So Durvasa Muni, you never have to mess with Durvasa Muni because he easily gives curse. And then Durvasa Muni, he was very angry on this girl, but he tried to control his anger because she was already in pitiful condition. So he controlled his anger and told to this girl, I am not cursing you because you are already in pitiful condition, but the way you have blasphemed this Purushottam month, this very glorious month, you are definitely going to reap the sin for that. So then what happened, as soon as Durvasa Muni leave in anger, and this girl, all her beauty start fading, and all her opulences, whatever little bit opulence she has, started, diminishing everything. Then she became more morose. And then she thought of taking shelter. So she took shelter of Lord Shiva and she started performing the meditation. It has been mentioned that she used to perform very, very severe meditation. Like in the summer, she used to lit a fire around her, and then she used to perform austerities. In the freezing cold, she used to go, she will be in the water and performing austerity. And when Lord Shiva was pleased, he came and he asked, he was very much pleased with this girl's austerity. And then he come and then he asked, okay, I'm very pleased with you. Tell me, what do you want? So what benediction would you like to take from me? Then this girl told that, I want a husband. give me a husband. I want a husband. So like, so she says five times. So she, sometime when, you know, we do not know how much we should speak. So this girl, she says five times. And then obviously Lord Shiva has heard it five times. And then Lord Shiva says Tathastu. So then Lord Shiva says, you will have five husbands. So then this girl realized, no, I did not ask for five husbands. But Lord Shiva says, I have heard you saying five times. So I thought you want five husbands. So that's how. Now she says, please take it back. Then Lord Shiva says, no, I cannot take it back. It will not happen in this life, but you will, in your next life, you will have five husbands, but they will be very unique. You know, she eventually she leave her body, and there when Drupada Maharaj performed this yajna, so then Draupadi, as the same girl born as a Draupadi, comes from that fire sacrifice. And she is called Draupadi because she was the daughter of Drupad Maharaj. So that's how they were occurring because of, you know, not recognizing the glories of Purushottam Mantra. So these were some discussions about Purushottam. So I'm also remembering one of the pastime which I would like to share. So one time, very, very glorious this month to perform any of the devotional activities. We'll see from this pastime also. There was a king called Hadadhanva. This, all these glories and pastime of Purushottam Mantra are mentioned in Padma Purana and Skanda Purana. So this is a pastime from Padma Purana, where this King Hadadhanva, he was the son of Chitradhanva. So this King Hadadhanva, he was very good, you know, he had so much of opulence, he had five kids and everything was going very well. So one time he went to the forest, you know, king goes to the forest for hunting. So one time he went and he was pursuing the deer. Then when he went inside and, you know, he was tired. So he thought of taking rest. He, you know, lie down, he lie down near a tree, and then there was a parrot, and this parrot was saying, earlier it has been mentioned the king used to be very intelligent, so they used to even understand the language of the the language of the animals, the birds. So this parrot was saying that after achieving the opulence, people forget the supreme personality of Godhead. So the parrot was repeating, after achieving the opulence, people forget to worship the supreme personality of Godhead, like that. And this king was saying, why this, you know, he was thinking. So he came back to his kingdom, and I think this was Valmiki Muni who came to visit him. This king was very morose. Rishi asked, why you are, in this condition, what you are thinking of? Then he said this, I went there and the parrot was saying, I don't know, what does that mean? So then, you know, they have the power. These rishis are having mystic power. So they could see the present or the past also. So he meditated and then he came to know this parrot was the son of this king in the last life. So then he started narrating his last life story. So he said, king, who is a king, is a Hadadhanva. I hope everyone is following till now. So Hadadhanva king, in his previous life, he was Sudeva Brahmana. So he was a Brahmana, very, very pious Brahmana. Sudeva was his name, and his wife name was Gautami, the daughter of Gautam Rishi. So they were both married. They were very nice couple. They used to worship the Lord, but they did not have any son. So they did not have any progeny. So then this king, you know, this king in his previous life, when he was a Brahmana, Sudeva, he thought that, you know, there is no point for me to live because we don't have any son. So we will carry our ritualistic activities. And, you know, he was very much worried because he did not have any son. And he also told Gautami that, let me suicide. Like that he had a thought in his mind. So this Gautami, being a Rishi's daughter, she told her, no, you are a Vaishnava. How can you think of, how can you think like that? You should not give up your life. Instead, we will worship the supreme personality of Godhead. So they both started worshiping, and it has been mentioned, I think they worshiped for around 4,000 years. And then after 4,000 years, Lord Vishnu comes. So Lord Vishnu comes, and then Sudeva Brahmana and this his wife, they offer obeisances to the Lord. And then Lord Vishnu said, I am very pleased. Let me know what you want. So then Sudeva Brahmana, as he had a desire to have a son, so he told that, I want a son. Then Lord Vishnu said, no, ask me something else. So then, you know, he simply fainted because he did that tapasya for 4,000 years. And after that, the Lord says that he cannot have a son. He simply fainted by listening this. So Garuda, being a devotee, you know, he's a Lord carrier. He told, he started fanning Sudeva Brahmana. And then he was also telling the Lord, please give him a son, he's asking. So then Lord Vishnu, because why Lord Vishnu said like that? Because he said, you should not have the son for yours, I think, another some lifetime. So, but this, you know, he simply fainted, did not listen anything else. Then, Lord Vishnu told, why don't you give him a benediction then to fulfill your benediction? Whose benediction? Garuda benediction, like he's also the devotee, right? So you give the benediction and then I will fulfill that. And then, he will have a son. So likewise, Garuda gave the benediction and he started fanning also. Then he came into senses. Brahmana Sudeva. So then after that they had they had a son named I think Sukadeva. So they were I think one of the Rishi, I forgot, Devala Rishi, I think, yeah. Till Devala Rishi visited them, they were very happy. Devala Rishi came and as they served him very well, and then they asked the Rishi to give the benediction to his son. So then he said, and I think before they had a son, they performed this Purushottam mantra, these two couple. That's how they got that benediction. And then, they have observed, I think the Lord said to observe the Purushottam mantra completely. They observed it. And then later, they had the son. This Devala Muni, when he was about to give benediction, he realized that this son is a very short life. So he doesn't have much life. So as predicted by Devala Rishi, one time when this boy went with his other friends to swim in the ocean, the waves just dragged him away and he was dead. So then all these friends, the boy friends who were there, they came and told Gautami and Sudeva Brahmana that your child has been drowned. So like that. And then, they came there and they saw his dead body, and they were very, 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 very much disheartened. So they were crying. Sorry, they did not perform before they had a son, but now at this point, since you have multiple stories. So, Brahmana, they were crying and praying to the Supreme Lord. They were chanting and they were praying to the Supreme Lord. They were just chanting, and it so happened that when they were chanting and they were crying for their dead son, it was a Purushottam month. So that was a Purushottam month. Then for 30 days they did not eat, they did not sleep, they did not do anything apart from chanting Lord's name. And this is how we see devotee's condition. So if a devotee is there, they will have every reason to go to the Lord. If they are distressed, they will go to the Lord. If they are very happy, they will think, okay, Lord is so merciful to me, let me worship the Lord. But materialistic people, the difference is that they never want to go to the Lord. So how? If a materialistic person is there, you ask them, come to the temple. So they will say, if they are very happy, their life is going very well, their marriage life is going very well, they have a nice kids, their job is going very well.
So Mama?
Yes, Tulsi?
So then we are going to leave the class.
After some time, Tulsi. So when, sorry, what I was saying. Yeah. So this materialistic people, their life is going very nice. They will say that we do not want to go. Why do we want to go? We are very happy. We are very busy. We have so much things to do. We don't have time to go to the Lord. And then when they are distressed, you know, they have some bad in their life, they will say that, why should I go to the temple? What did the Lord did with me? This I am going to this distressful condition. That they never go to the Lord. But a devotee is one who goes to the Lord in every situation. It's a bad situation, it's a good situation, he will go. He's a Lord is only the shelter for the devotee. That is a devotee. So then, you know, they started crying and only chanting. Then this happens to be Purushottam month, and then Lord Vishnu appeared, and then he gave the benediction to them because they have, even though unknowingly, performed very, very kathor vrata for this Purushottam month. So they got the benediction that their son will, you know, they wanted just to revive their son. So Lord can do anything, we know. In the case of Sandipani Muni's son also, when Krishna and Balram, they got him back. So when it has, when Krishna has been asked from the Guru that you get their son back to the life. So similarly here, Lord got back this son, Sukadeva, to his life, and then he also gave the benediction that he will live for another 12,000 years, and after that he will come to my abode. So this is all, this story has been, told, that it will teach us that how much benediction this Purushottama month can give us. Because since this was a Brahmana, he got us so much of opulences even in his next life. And the Lord is so merciful so that he doesn't forget, because he's having so much of opulences. So he sent his son in the form of a parrot, and then he teaches him that, okay, you have to perform the devotional service also. So that's how we see the glories of Purushottaman. So whoever observes Purushottaman will be glorious in this life, next life, as well as he attains the Lord abode. So I will also discuss some things which we can do in the Purushottaman as it is starting from tomorrow. And then we will also go for the translation for the Chara Astakam. A very, very beautiful, written by Bilwa Mangal Thakur, another great devotee of the Lord. So give me just one second. And some munis, you know, they have told some statement about this Purushottam month. Let me pull that out so that I can read that as it is. So meanwhile, anyone has anything to share or anything, any questions to ask? Meanwhile, when I pull that up. Yes. So I got that. So glories of the Purushottam month. So what does Lord Krishna say? Lord Krishna, Purushottam month, as we all know, who is Purushottam? Purushottam is Jagannath Ji and is Lord Krishna. So Purushottam month has all the power. I have blessed its observer. One who follow Purushottam Vrata will destroy all his past sinful reactions. Without performing Purushottam Vrata, one cannot perform pure devotional service. The value of Purushottam month is far more valuable than all other types of austerities and religious activities mentioned in the Vedas. Anyone who observes Purushottama Vrat will return to my abode Goloka at the end of his life. Durvasa Muni, what does he say? Just by bathing in a holy river during Purushottama month, one becomes sinless. The glories of all other month is not equal to 1/16 of the glory of the Purushottama month. By bathing in a holy place, giving in charity, chanting the holy name of Krishna during Purushottama month, all miseries are destroyed. One attains all kind of perfection and fulfills all his desires. So what does Valmiki Muni says? By observing Purushottama Vrat, one attains more benefit than performing 100 horse sacrifices. All holy places lives within the body of a Purushottama month vrati. Anyone who faithfully perform Purushottama Vrata will go to Gokula, Goloka, Vrindavan. Narada Muni, what does he say? So Purushottama month is the best of all month, vratas and austerities. Just by faithfully hearing the glories of Purushottama month, one attains Krishna bhakti and immediately nullifies all his sinful reactions. So not even just performing, even if we are hearing or we have heard the glories of Purushottama month, then also we nullifies our sin and we attain bhakti to Krishna. One who performs Purushottama vrata properly will attain unlimited sukruti. So what is that sukruti? It's not a material pious activity, it's a devotional merit and goes to the spiritual world. Okay, so these are some statements. So what we can do, because it's starting from tomorrow, so some things are recommended. So actually it's a good time to do all the devotional service. So some things are recommended. We should recite Jagannath Ashtakam. Vindashkan Yatra, if everybody remembers that we had this Jagannath Ashtakam, singing at the time of our program. So Jagannath Ashtakam, it's 8 verses glorifying Lord Jagannath. It can be sing. It should be sing in the morning time when we are doing the ghee lamp to Lord Krishna and Radharani. And we should also do Chaura Ashtakam. Very, very beautiful. We'll go to the translation of Chaura Ashtakam. So Chaura Ashtakam is written by Bilwa Mangal Thakur. And it should be sung in the evening time. And as far as possible, we should do the ghee lamp offering as we do in to Lord Damodar in the Damodar month. Similarly, in the Purushottama month, we should do the ghee lamp offering in the as far as possible both times. But if it not possible, then at least one time. But we should do two times. So do the ghee lamp, sing this Jagannath Ashtakam, Chaura Ashtakam, and then we should read the chapter Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam reading as much as we can. But we should specifically read Bhagavad Gita chapter 15, because it is called, what is it called? The chapter 15 name. Can anybody help me out? What is it called? Chapter 15, Bhagavad Gita. We have recently covered, yes, the supreme, the yoga of the supreme person. So that need to be recited every day. And apart from that, Brahma's stuti. So that is there in 10th canto, I think 14th chapter. Brahma stuti should be should be sing or read from the Srimad Bhagavatam. And we have also chanted the holy name. So this month is kind of a sale. So as we see the sale in this world, like the Diwali sale or the Sera sale, or you have a Christmas sale, Thanksgiving sale. So this is a very, very higher sale. These sales are all material sales. This is a spiritual sale where, we get, if we chant one round, we definitely get the higher benefit of chanting more rounds. So we can chant more round of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. If we cannot do more round, then we should also see if we can increase the quality. So chanting, Prabhupada says, chanting is 90% of the spiritual advancement. If we are not chanting properly, means we cannot advance in our spiritual life. So our life will be stagnant. Our spiritual life will be stagnant. So chanting is very, very important. Even though we hear it, but it is very, very, Maya is very strong. So we forget, right? We have to chant in it. We don't have to chant attentively. We have to chant attentively because we are calling Krishna's name, Kali Kale Naam Rupe Krishna Avatar. So it's Krishna we are directly associating with the Lord. There is no difference between the Lord and the Lord holy name, but we are not yet purified to understand that completely. But as we progress by doing attentive chanting, we will be able to see the effect of chanting. And what is the effect of chanting? Can anybody let me know? What does Prabhupada say? What is the effect of chanting?
More chanting.
So effect of chanting is more chanting, because when you chant attentively, you will be able to chant more. Why we can't finish our round? What is the problem? Why this 16 round also is so difficult? Because we are not getting the taste in chanting. because we are doing somehow the other, we are doing the offenses. So we have to be very careful. In this month, we have to be also very careful. Even though we have to 12 months also, we should not offend the devotees. But in this month, we have to be very careful not offending anyone and not being prajalpa, no gossipings. And as far as possible, utilize our complete time in performing these devotional service that what I have just mentioned, and as much as read Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, sing this glory, offered ghee lamb to the Lord, all these things. If anybody has any comment, because we can take that and then we'll go to the translation for the Chaurashtakam. It's very, very beautiful. Okay, if not, then we have time.
What did you want? What was the question?
No, I was saying if anyone has any comment, we can take that and then we will go to the translation for Chaurashtakam. My voice is not
Hare clear. Krishna Mataji, I had a question.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, yeah, Prabhuji.
Yes, Mataji. So actually, the question is in two parts. You started off with explaining Chaturmas. So, I was also listening to the lecture at Mayapur and I was reading some of the blogs, ISKCON blogs. So I just wanted to understand that, I got an indication that Chaturmas, the fasting in Chaturmas from specific items is observed because they also have some scientific implications because of, weather change, monsoon month, we should avoid leafy vegetables and then milk and yogurt. So, Mataji, just wanted to understand, I don't have any scriptural references, but just wanted to understand what exactly is the, reason behind these restrictions.
So, Prabhuji, I think from the observer point of view, I think we should observe this because these are recommended that we should fast from the leafy vegetable from the first month. And I think somebody was saying about, scientific reason, as we have for Ekadashi also, we observe it as a scriptural injunction, but for scientific reason for this is, I think for the monsoon season, there will be more insects and all these things. So green leafy vegetable might be more contaminated status. So that's why we should not have it. But I'm not sure about the milk and all those, but for green leafy vegetable, I know if anybody has anything to share to Prabhu's question, they can share definitely. They can, if they have any input, they can share. But for the leafy vegetable, I know scientifically means it will be having more contamination. So we should not have it. But then I don't know about milk and all. But it is definitely scriptural. So we are all following because it's mentioned in the scriptures, these 4 months, Chaturmas. And all these months are very, very conducive to devotional service. As we know, right, in 4 months, whoever will be the more elevated spiritualist, they do not even go. They will have, and I remember from Chaitanya Chaitamrita, this civilization, modern civilization is very bad. But in the earlier, when at the time of even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they were all the householder. They used to leave everything and go for 4 months. They stay at Jagannath Puri. So they do the Dhamavas for 4 months, have the association of, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and absorb themselves completely 4 months in the devotional service. But our condition is not like that. But every year we have Chaturmas, but this Purushottam month will be only for after 3 years. So we should take best possible advantage for this from this month of Prabhu. That's what I can answer. Is that okay, Prabhu?
So Padmalochini, I can understand sannyasi is going away for 4 months, but householders could go away for 4 months. How would they earn their living?
Yeah, it is mentioned in the, it was mentioned, I think I was hearing one of the lecture earlier for Chaturmas from one of the Prabhujis, maybe Amrendra Prabhu. He was mentioning, they used to be there for 4 months. And I think it is there in Chaitanya Chaitamrita as well. I'm not recollecting exact where it is, but they used to go for 4 months. They used to stay there in Jagannath Puri. Yeah, that is what I'm saying. It was, so beautiful at that time also. They are very simple living, Mataji. So
I can understand. Yeah.
Yes, Mataji, I had also heard something similar. So just wanted to you know, have a better explanation. I also heard different versions, like you know, some somewhere, and I heard in one of the lectures that some people also believe that it is not recommended to shave during this time. So I wasn't very sure. So wanted to check on that.
That is true.
Mataji, I'll come to.
Mataji, go ahead.
Yeah, I'll come to the second part of the question, Mataji. As I was saying, there's another you know, added question that I had. So during the Purushottam month, so again, you know, the weather conditions are transitioning, that is understood. But why, again, if we are fasting from certain items, why do we suspend it for an interim period and then resume that fasting of, from that item again? Again, going by the weather implications, weather change implications.
Interrupted because this Purushottam month is a extra month. It is not coming under the part of a Chaturmas, so that's the reason. If you remember in India, you know, Shraddha happens, right? This is the Shraddha period going on, Pitra Paksha, and after the Shraddha, definitely, if you remember, every month comes Navratri, right? You are from Bengal, so Navratri comes after. As soon as Shraddha ends, Navratri comes, and then Dasera, and then all the festival. But since this month is added and it is not coming as a part of Chaturmas, it is not a Chaturmas. This Purushottam month is not a part of the Chaturmas. That's why. Otherwise, the fasting will be Prabhu if you continue, right? So I think we started from September 1st, and if you continue, if you see the ISKCON calendar, it will say the end of Chaturmas is when the Kartik Mata, I think 1st November or some date will be there. So then it will be 1.5 month fasting of milk, right? Or yeah, 2 months, exactly 2 months, September 1 to October, November. So we because we are following Chaturmas, so it would be 4 months. Purushottam month is outside of Chaturmas. That's why you break that, and then you are not breaking it because this is not a part of Chaturmas. So you put a pause here, and then you resume it at when Chaturmas is starting after Purushottam month is ending. 16th October, I think from 17th we resume, Prabhuji. Is that answer?
Yes, Mataji, thank you very much.
And Padmalochini, not just in the, even 500, in the town that I grew up, the sannyasis would do Chaturmas, you know, in some temple for 4 months. And the householders surrounding the temple would go to the temple more often. There would be more, you know, discussions, you know, spiritual discussions in the temple because of the Swamiji's doing Chaturmas there. So there would be a lot of sannyasis doing Chaturmas in the different temples. But the householders would just probably fast, but in place, you know, they around the temple. That's, yeah. That happened even in the town that I grew up in, you know.
Oh, very nice, Mataji. Very nice culture, right?
Yeah, very nice culture. I mean, I really feel sad that the culture that I grew up in is not there anymore, you know, which was only like 50 years ago.
So you remember, right, Narada Muni, I will not go into the detail because we have to do the translation for Chaurashtakam. So you remember for Narada Muni also, he served the sannyasis and Bhakti Vedantas who came at the time of Chaturmas, and his mother has in his previous life, then he became Narada Muni, right? We know that is also from the Chaturmas. He has served the sannyasis and Bhakti Vedantas in Chaturmas from first canto. Srimad Bhagavatam, when Narada Muni says about his past life. So we'll, if you see here, is Bilwa Mangal Thakur. So just a little background, not completely. Bilwa Mangal Thakur, he was very much attached to a prostitute called Chintamani, and he used to associate with her. But what happens at one time when his father died, and then he, you know, his final rites were going on. But Bilwa Mangal Thakur, being so attached to this Chintamani, he even was scolding the priest to do this soon, because he wanted to go to Chintamani. But that time there was a high, you know, very much rainfall. And then this Bilwa Mangal Thakur, Chintamani thought that he will not come today. So she just slept, and this Bilwa Mangal Thakur, he wanted to go to Chintamani. So he, even though there was a high, heavy rainfall, he goes, and there was a, you know, river need to be crossed between. So he was so much blind by, you know, by his lusty desires that he even, it has been mentioned that he crossed this on the corpse. So there was a corpse flowing, and he crossed that river. And then when he went, she was staying at fourth floor. So he thought, because it was a night time, everything will be locked. And, you know, so he thought of going through the window. So he thought of one rope. He thought that Chintamani has, put it down, but it was not the rope. It was mentioned that it was a snake, but he was so became blind from his lusty desire that he climbed that up and went. And then this, Chintamani told him one thing. She told, whatever attraction you have for me, if you would have that attachment to Lord Krishna, your life will be successful. And then from there, Chintamani, this Bilwa Mangal Thakur, he just leave everything and he wanted to go to Vrindavan. Before going to Vrindavan, he has a bad desire with one of the Brahmana lady. He thought about that. And then with the same lady, he asked the two pins, hair pins with Mataji puts, and he he pricked his two eyes. So he was completely blind because he thought that these two eyes are coming between me and Krishna. And then he goes, he stays in Vrindavan, and he has composed very, very beautiful verses. So this is Bilwa Mangal Thakur, and I will also share this. Let me share one more time. I'll stop share and share the Vraja Prasiddham one. I have just pulled that out.
Mataji, I heard this story similar for Tulsidas also, who has written Ramcharitmanas also. Like he have also much in love with his wife. He crossed the river on the dead body. I don't know. It's a similar story I have heard.
Okay, Prabhu. I am not sure about that, Prabhu. Tulsidas stories, yeah, it might be. So I don't know. I'll just share. Why it is not displaying there that content which I want to share. Yeah, I got it now. So everybody will be able to see my screen, right? So then we'll just go over this translation. So and the verses also. So then he composed. So what time then? Because he has given everything to Krishna. So now Krishna, he says, he will protect the devotee. So even though when a devotee is giving everything, he has given even his eyes. So Krishna's responsibility is now to protect him. So when he was staying in Vrindavan, he used to compose bhajan, and Krishna used to come in the Gopala form, and he used to deliver the milk to Bilwa Mangal Thakur every day. So nice, right? If you meditate on that. So every day Lord is coming and delivering the milk to Bilwa Mangal Thakur. And then he used to ask, who are you? Then he says, I am a Bal Gopal, and I see that you are not having anything, drinking anything. So I came here with this milk, so please drink this. Like that he used to come every day. So one time, because he was blind, he fall down in a dry well. And then he says, la, 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 la. And then Krishna comes, and he pulled Bilwa Mangal Thakur from his hand. Till now, Bilwa Mangal Thakur has not touched the Lord, right? He is just giving the milk and he was taking the milk. But this time, since Lord has touched his hand, so he, Bilwa Mangal Thakur, even though he was blind, but he was spiritually very advanced. So he told, you are Krishna, right? You are Krishna, he says. But Krishna, Bal Gopal, he just ran away at that time. So then he composed this beautiful, prayer. So I'll just sing. Praje prasitham navanita chauram gopanganam chatukula chauram anika janma jita papa chauram charagriganyam purusham namami. So what does Bilwa Mangal Thakur says? He says him, chore, you are a thief. So Vraja Prasiddham, you are famous in Vraja. So why you are famous? Because you are a thief. What do you steal? You steal the butter. And what else? You doesn't even steal the butter. What do you steal? You steal the clothes of the gopi. We know the Vastaharan Leela. So you steal the Dukula, means cloth of the whom? The gopis. And not even this, you are a thief. Why you are a thief? Because you steal the papa, the sins of all the people, aneka janma. So whatever aneka janma we have performed, you know, we have performed the sins, that also this thief, because Bilwa Mangal Thakur saying him as a thief, you steal that. So if you see in the translation, you know, those who ever take shelter of you still the sins which they have occurred, so which they have occurred over the many lifetime. And he is calling Chara Garganyam Purusha Namami. So you are the foremost of the thief. So Shri Radhikaya Hridayasya Chauram Navambhuta Shamala Kanti Chauram Patashitanam Cha Samasta Chauram Charagriganyam Purusham Namami. So what does he say? He say you itna hi nahi. I mean, you just not stop here. What does you do? You steal the heart, Sri Radhikaya Hridayasya Chauram. So you steal the heart of Srimati Radhika Rani. And you are a thief. You even you steal the heart of Radhika Rani, you steal the color of the cloud. So fresh rain cloud color. So Bilwa Mangal Thakur is saying you are even stealing that luster, that color, and applying it on your body. So that type of thief you are. And what is a padashritam, right? So he says that who steals the suffering, so those whoever will take. So if you go back here, you see the third line, padashritam cha samasta papa chauram. So what you do, you steals all the suffering of those who take shelter of you. So you are a thief because you steal. So third verse says, akinchani krita padashritam ya karoti bhikshum pati gena heenam kena piyaho bhishana chara etre drishta shruto va na jagatriyapi. So in the third paragraph, what Bilwa Mangal Thakur is saying that you, whoever takes shelter of you, so you make them into a pauper and wandering homeless beggar. Alas, such a fearsome thief has never been seen and heard in the three world. So what does that mean? Then Krishna will make, if you take shelter of Krishna, Krishna will make you beggarless. Does anybody remembering any verses from Bhagavatam? So Prabhupada speaks about it, right? It's a special mercy, and special mercy Krishna will not give to everybody. Those whoever is very, very close to Krishna, those people will get that special mercy. So that special mercy is 10:88, Yasyam Anugrahanami Hariyashchetad Dhananshane. So that verse where it says when Krishna will bestow his special mercy, takes away all the wealth, and then his relatives, everybody will, you know, leave him, and then he doesn't have any shelter. Because if you have everything good, then you will say, okay, sab achha chal raha hai, I am going very well in my life, why should I go to the temple like that? So, but Krishna, if you want to show special mercy, because he want you to love only him, the possessive God, so he make the devotee as a homeless beggar. So,
Hare Krishna Mataji, can you hear me?
Sorry, you have a class, right? Sorry.
So, we are time check, just to see you are checking the time.
Yeah, Prabhu, can I take 2 more minutes just to finish this quickly?
Yeah, I mean, whatever, just want to make sure, you know, I'm sorry for disturbance.
Yeah, Prabhu. So just 2-3 minutes, I will finish it, Prabhu. So yadya namapi harita shesham giri parashana pipa parashin ascharya rupo nanuchara edrik drishta shruto va namaya kadapi. So mere utterance of his name purchased one of a mountains of sins. Such an astonishingly wonderful thief I have never seen or heard before. So we'll not go into much detail, but here it clearly mentioned that whoever takes the name of that thief, who is Krishna, whatever sins he have committed, even mountains of sin, can be purchased with his name, with uttering his name. So such a wonderful thief has never been seen, and Bilwa Mangal Thakur is saying and heard before. Dhanam cha manam cha tathendriyani pranam charitva mama sarva eva palashaye kutra dritto adya chara tvam bhakti damna shimaya nirutha. So we'll go to the fifth one. What does it say? Oh, thief, having stolen my wealth. So that this particular is right for Bilwa Mangala Thakur, is same for himself, because he has taken his wealth, his honor, his incenses also, because he has given even his eyes to Krishna and my life, everything. Now you are running. You are not even giving me your association because Krishna is running. So, but he is saying, I have caught you with the rope of my devotion, you know. And then he says very beautiful line here. Chinanti ghoram yamapasha bandham dinasti bhinnam bhavapasha bandham chinasti sarvasya samasta bandham nevatmano bhakta kritam tu bandham. So he says, I have caught you, right? You are running, but I have caught you. So what does he say? You can run, but you cannot run from my heart because I have caught you with the rope of my devotion. So he says, you can cut the terrible nose of Yamraja, because who is Krishna? Krishna is Mukunda, the giver of the liberation. So whoever chants Krishna's name, they never see Yamdutas. So you sever the dreadful nose of material existence and you slash everyone's material bondage. But he says he's very confident you are unable to cut the knot fastened by your own loving devotee. So basically he's saying that you cannot cut the knot from which I have bound to you. So quickly we'll go to 7th and 8th, and then we'll end. Mana mana se tamasarashi ghore karagrehe dukha mayani patha labasvahe chara hare chiraya sa chara dosha chitame vadandam. So now is a thief, right? He has told the whatever activities Krishna has performed. Then if one is a thief, then he has to have some punishment. So what does Bilwa Mangala Thakur is saying? Oh, stealer of my everything. Oh, thief, today I have imprisoned you. Since you are a thief, I have imprisoned you in a miserable prison house of my heart. His heart is not miserable prison house, but he's mentioning because our heart is like black, dirty, full of all anarthas. So he is mentioning my heart, which is very fearful due to the terrible darkness of my ignorance, and there for a long time you will remain receiving appropriate punishment for your crimes of thievery. So whatever activities you have performed, criminal activities, you will be going to bind in my dark well of my heart. Karagrahe vasa sadaridaye madai matvakti pashadda bandhana nischalasan tvam krishna he pralaya koti satantare api sarvasva chaura hridaya nahi mochami. So if the thief is there, they get the punishment of 6 months, 1 year, depending upon how much have they steal, how many times they have steal. But here what Bilwa Mangala Thakur is saying, very beautiful statement. Oh Krishna, thief of my everything, the nose of my devotion remaining forever tight, you will continue to reside in the prison house of my heart, because I will not release you for millions of points. So even though you have performed this thievery, I will not release you of this punishment, because I have caught you in my heart, in my prison house of my heart, and I will not release you for millions of years. So I would like to take a pause here, since we are already 8 minutes. Sorry for going a bit over eight minutes from our time. But this is what I had to share, and I would request everyone to observe this Purushottam Vrata. And somebody also take the Vrata, they will have milk. I mean, it is not necessary, but some devotees, they take milk, fruits, they take one time food, but it is depending upon us. But whatever I've shared earlier, chanting, offering ghee lamp, that all those things are very important to do on this Purushottam month. So let us pray to Lord that he will give us strength to perform Purushottam Vrata. Hare Krishna. Thank you everyone for joining.
Hare Krishna. Before we leave, quick announcement. As Mataji has explained beautifully this Chatur Chaurashtakam, so we will be chanting Chaurashtakam daily starting from tomorrow at 6:45 for 1 month. So please join 15 minutes before our regular Bhagavad Gita class, so that we will chant Chaurashtakam. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhu. Very nice.
Thank you, Padmalakshmi. That was really beautiful. Thanks. Vancha kalpataravyascha kripa sindhavyeva cha patitanam bhavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namah.